Hello everybody, today I want to discuss the chemical formula, how we can write the chemical formula and what are the rules for writing the chemical formulas. That chemical formula may be of molecular compound and may be of ionic compound also. Okay, so now I want to start the molecular formula that will be formed by the ionic compound. Okay, ionic compound, you know that these are contains positive and negative ions. What they will represent? Actually, chemical compound of chemical formula of ionic compound mainly simply represents the ratio of the cations and anions present in the structure of the compound. Okay, and what are the rules for writing the these formulas? First of all, we should write down the symbols of the element from which you will form the compound. You want to form the compound. Okay, so write down the symbol of the ions present in the compound as a convention. The cation, that is positive ion, is written on the left hand side and the negative ion is written on the right hand side. For example, if we want to write the formula of sodium chloride, then how we can write? So first we'll write the Na and Cl. So this is left side, cation is on left side and anion is on right side. So this is the first rule for writing the ionic compound. Okay, and every time it should be just remember by you that you should write the cation on the left side and anion on the right hand side. Okay, now what is the second rule? What we will do after this writing the symbol of the element? After writing the symbol of the elements, we should write the valency of each atom or radical below its symbol. For example, we have written the symbol, that is NaCl. So what we will do after that? We will return the symbol, then after that we will write the valency below this radical, maybe the radical or maybe the atom. So you can write the valency here, one valency, and here one valency. If the valencies are common, then no need of writing them, because you can take the common factor from them and divide it by the common factor. So same valencies will be there, then they will be omitted. Okay, so you will write the formula. The third is, second step is that you will write the valency of both the radicals or both the atoms below its below the atom. So you have written this valency. Okay, now what is the third step? Third step, finally cross over the valency so that they appear on the lower right side of the atom or radical. What you will do in third step? You will write the cross over the valencies. For example, if you are taking NaCl, you have written the valency below the atom, then you will cross over the valency and write the valency below the atom, means as a subscript. You can write like that. That valency is 1, so you can write 1. Cl valency 1, you can write 1. Both the valencies are same, so you will omit this valency because both has one valency, and just off the brackets also, and you will write the final formula, that is NaCl. So this is the formula of sodium chloride. Okay, so it is NaCl is the formula of sodium chloride. So these are the main three steps from which you can write the formula, and you can learn these steps and you can write the formula easily with the help of these steps. So these are the steps for writing, and more steps are also there. That will be the exceptional for not for all the compounds, but for some compounds. Now, next rule, if there is a common factor between the valencies of the cation and anion, the valencies are divided by common factor. For example, we can take calcium and oxygen. Valency of calcium is 2 and oxygen is also 2. Okay, so if we will cross over the valency, the formula becomes Ca2 and O2. We can take the common factor 2 and divide them, then we will get 1. So CaO is the formula. We can take another formula like Mg, magnesium and oxygen. So we can make magnesium oxide. This is calcium oxide. We can make the magnesium oxide also. The same valency will be there. Here valency of magnesium is 2 and oxygen also 2. Cross over the valency, then we will get MgO because the valencies are same. We can take the common factor 2. We can take another example like carbon and oxygen. This compound is molecular compound mainly, it is not ionic compound. We can take the valency of carbon 4 and oxygen 2. 2 1 ja and 2 2 ja 4. Okay, so we can cross over the valency and our formula becomes CO2. So here we can take 2 common factor and divide them. So like that we can make the formula. If there is a common factor between the valencies, then we can take the common factor and divide them. So we will get the final formula of this. Now next case, in the case of ionic compound containing polyatomic ions, actually if the polyatomic ions are not present, then there will be no problem. But if there will be the compounds that contain polyatomic ions means group of atoms which carry charge. So the formula of the polyatomic ion is written in brackets and the valency is written below as in above cases, like that we have done. On the basis we have written the valencies. So same we will do. We will write the valencies at the bottom as a subscript. Now if one appears on the lower right hand side of the polyatomic ion, the brackets are omitted. If in the right hand side there will be the 1, then the brackets are omitted, otherwise brackets are not omitted. So let us take the examples of them. First we can take the example of calcium hydroxide. We can make the formula of calcium hydroxide. We can take calcium and OH is a OH negative, that is polyatomic ion. So its valency is 1 and calcium valency is 2. Now what you will do? Cross over the valencies. What we will get? Ca1 and OH whole twice. Okay. Now this is right hand side. Right hand side will get the 2. So we don't want to omit the bracket. So bracket remains as it is. But this consists 1 only. So we can omit this bracket and our formula becomes CaOH whole twice. So this is the formula of calcium hydroxide. Okay. Now we can take the another example like sodium carbonate. Okay. So we can write here sodium and carbonate CO3. Its valency is 2. Okay. And the valency of sodium is 1. What we will do? Cross over the valency. Then what we will get? We can get Na2 At the base we will write 2 and CO3 1. What we will do? If there will be 1, then we can omit the bracket. Okay, and here 2 is given, so it is right side, so right side bracket will be omitted. Okay, and that bracket will not, we will not represent this bracket because right hand side will bracket will be omitted if the 1 appears at the base, means as a subscript. So formula becomes Na2CO3. Okay, so this is the formula of sodium carbonate. Okay, Na2CO3. So just you will check the right side should be there. If there will be the right side, every time the polyatomic ions should be written on the right hand side because they are anions. Okay, so polyatomic ions are anions. So what you will do? You will right hand. You will write in them in the right hand side. And if right hand side there will be the one valency as a subscript, so what you will do? You will omit the bracket. And left hand side, no problem. We will not kept under it in the bracket. Okay, only polyatomic ions should be in the brackets. Now next rule, we can write the next rule, that will be the last rule for it, that is sixth rule. So we can write the sixth rule, last one. While writing the final formula of ionic compound, what you will do? What you will do if you are writing? Actually, if we are writing the final formula of the ionic compound, then there will be no need of writing the minus and plus. That means the minus sign and plus sign of the elements or atoms, or you can say that cations contains positive ions, so positive sign will be there, so no need of writing that sign. So you can write, we usually do not write the charges on the symbols of the ions. The charges may be minus or plus on the symbols of the ions. Okay, like that. Here we have not written the charges, we have written CaOH whole twice, so the charges we will not write. If you have written in like that, you have written the charges over there, so you can write like that also. But at last, whenever you are writing the final formula, then remove these charges. Like that you can write, if you are writing NaCl, you are writing here charge plus 1 valency, here minus 1 valency, cross over the valency. Next you will put the bracket and write the charges here, minus 1 and below, and with the chlorine plus 1. Okay, then what you will do? Finally, 1 is there, so you will remove both the brackets and you will write NaCl and remove the minus and plus charges also. So this is the final formula of sodium chloride. So like that you can write the final formulas. And now we can discuss the other formulas of some chemical compounds or some ionic compounds. So we have discussed But some formulas we can also discuss. I want to rub the board. If you have written, it's very good. If you are not right, so please pause the video and write these notes according. Okay. Now let's do the sum. Another formulas of ionic compounds. So every student have cleared their doubts accordingly. We have make the formula, already make the formula of sodium chloride, then sodium carbonate, then calcium hydroxide, then magnesium oxide. Now we can make these formulas again also, then you can understood how the formula will be made. Okay, how you can make the formula, then practice should be necessary for you. So please do the practice. So chemical formula of some simple compounds. Chemical formula of some simple compounds. Okay. You can take the example of sodium chloride that we have also done. So you can write the formation of sodium chloride, formation of magnesium chloride. So first you can take formation of sodium chloride. Okay. Every time you will put the positive ion first, cation first. So cation is sodium Na and chlorine is anion. So chloride ion is here. So we will take the write the valency here. Now what you will do? Cross over the valencies, then write these valencies at the base of the atom like that. And if the both one factor is common, one is there, so omit this one, and at final you will write NaCl. So this is the formula of sodium chloride. Okay, so you can write here also NaCl. Got it? Now sometimes you can see the some formulas like that, CaCl2, MgCl2. So how they will be formed? So let us write this formula also. So we'll start the formation of magnesium chloride. So we can do the magnesium chloride next formula. Write the magnesium chloride here. Magnesium chloride. Okay. Now what is the symbol of magnesium? Mg. And chloride Cl. Okay. Now the valency of magnesium 2 and here 1. What you will do? Cross over the valencies. You will get Mg minus 1 at the base as in subscript, and chlorine at the base plus 2. Okay. Now what you will do? You will just omit the brackets. Okay, if one is there, no need of writing the brackets. Two is there, no need of writing the bracket. But if the polyatomic ion is there, then you have to put the bracket. Okay, so this is not a polyatomic ion, this is an ion. So what you will do? You will write directly MgCl2. So this is the formula of magnesium chloride. You can write MgCl2. Okay. Now another formula you can write, the magnesium chloride you have written already. So you can make the formation of calcium oxide. Okay. You can make the formula of sodium oxide. So any oxide, chloride, you can make the formula of that, or sulfide or hydride. Okay. Like that the formula should be with you, and you can easily practice of each formulas
accordingly. So you can make the another formula. Okay, so two formulas we have done. Now next one, two, and third we can start. So we'll write formation of calcium oxide. Calcium oxide. So what is the symbol of calcium? Ca, and oxide, oxygen. Write the valency here, plus 2 air, minus 2. What you will do? Cross over the valencies. Valencies are same. So you can see that if they are same, they are not present. They will be divided by the same factor, common factor, 1. 2 1 jar, 2 1 jar. Then it will be divided. Then what will come? CaO. So calcium oxide formula is CaO. Okay. And you can write according to that. Now next formula we can write the aluminium oxide. That will be little bit different from that them. Why? Because the valencies differ. So you can write the another formula. Fourth, formation of aluminium chloride. Formation of aluminium chloride. Okay, how the aluminium chloride is formed? So what you will do? You will write the symbol of the element. What is the symbol of aluminium? Al. So you will write Al, and chloride Cl. What is the valency of aluminium? 3. What is the valency of chlorine? 1. So what you will do? Cross over the valency. Then you will get Al minus 1 and Cl plus 3. Both here, this is not a polyatomic ion, and minus plus, no need of writing at last. So what you will write? Finally, you will write the formula like that. AlCl3. Okay. So AlCl3 is the formula of aluminium chloride. Here also you can write AlCl3. Got it? So like that you can make the formulas. You can make another formula like aluminium oxide. So you can make the formula of aluminium oxide. After that you can understood how the formulas are formed. Finally, we can make the formula of aluminium oxide, and you can take the, you can also practice it. Aluminium oxide, we can make the formula, and this is the fifth number formula. So aluminium oxide, what is the symbol of aluminium? Al. And don't write like that A capital L. No, it becomes wrong. So A and small L will be there. Capital A and small L, and oxygen O. Okay. Now valency of aluminium is 3 and valency of oxygen is 2. What you will do? You will cross over the valency, write the valency at as in subscript. Okay, by bracket. So Al 2 ho gaya, then O 3. Okay. Now what you will do? Just omit these plus minus sign and bracket also, and write the final formula like that. Al2O3. So this is the formula of aluminium oxide. You can write the formula here also, Al2O3. So this is the formula of aluminium oxide. Okay, now we can make the formulas of compounds containing polyatomic ions also. So let us write some formula that will contain some polyatomic ions. Then all the doubts are clear. If you can make the formula, you can practice these. So let us write the formula. Okay. So let's do chemical formula of compounds containing polyatomic ions. So you will write chemical formula
of compounds containing polyatomic ions. Okay, polyatomic ions, because the rules are different for them. Polyatomic ions, every time we should write in the brackets, but the valency is one, then we will omit the bracket, otherwise the bracket should be there. Okay, so let's start. Formula of sodium nitrate, first is formula or formation of sodium nitrate. Sodium nitrate, but you should learn the polyatomic ions. What is the nitrate? What is the symbol of it that I have given in my previous video? Like NO3 negative, this is the nitrate. It means its valency is -1. Okay, so 1 is the valency here. You can write this formula of sodium nitrate. So what you will do, you will write the positive ion. So sodium is positive ion, sodium ion, then nitrate ion. Okay, a nitrate is polyatomic ion. So what you will do, you will dividing, you will write these polyatomic ion into the brackets, put them like that. We will write the sodium, okay, then NO3 is nitrate. Now what we will do, write the valency below the radical or below the atom. So the valency is +1, here -1. What you will do, cross over the valency, write the valency at the base as in subscript like that, NO3 +1 like that. Okay, now what you will do, if 1 is there, then omit the bracket. So 1 is there, omit the bracket. Here also in the right side you will omit the bracket, left side there will be no problem, you will omit the bracket every time. Okay, so you will write NaNO3. So this is the formula of sodium nitrate, NaNO3. Okay, so here also you can write the formula sodium nitrate, NaNO3. Got it? You can make the formula like that. Next, you can write the formula of calcium hydroxide. So make the formula of calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide or sodium sulfate, magnesium sulfate, magnesium nitrate, magnesium carbonate, magnesium hydrogen carbonate or hydrocarbonate. Okay, so like that you can make the different formulas of with the polyatomic ion. Okay, so you can write the formula of calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide or calcium carbonate, it's up to you. Okay, so this is the second formula. Now symbol of calcium, Ca, hydroxide, OH negative we are writing, it means its valency -1. So 1 is the valency here, +2 valency, here 1 valency. Cross over the valency. What I told you, you will write them in the bracket, and if the polyatomic ions are there, you can put the bracket and don't omit the bracket. Your formula becomes CaOH whole twice here. Okay, so the bracket remains as it is because the valency here 2 is there. So cross over, so right hand side will, if there will be 1, then you will omit the bracket, otherwise the bracket should be remain as it is in the case of polyatomic ion. So please remember it or note down. Okay, so the formula, final formula, is CaOH whole twice. This is the formula of calcium hydroxide. Okay, learn them. So no need of cramming these formulas, you can write them with the help of valencies and symbols of the elements. Next formula we can make, calcium carbonate.
You can make the calcium carbonate.
You know,
calcium has Ca and carbonate CO3. So its valency is 2 and its valency 2. Both valencies are same. That is common factor 2. So it is divided by 2. So what we'll get? We'll get CaCO3. So this is the formula of calcium carbonate. Okay. So you can write here CaCO3. This is the formula of calcium carbonate. Okay. You can make the formula of calcium hydrogen carbonate. How you can make? Now the same rules are there for the polyatomic ions. Okay, so calcium hydrogen carbonate, calcium hydrogen carbonate. Okay, so if hydrogen carbonate is there, then what is the radical? HCO3. And HCO3 we will write minus, so it means its valency is 1. Now write the formula CaHCO3 valency 1 and here calcium valency 2. Cross over the valencies, what you will get? You will write here Ca at the base 1 and HCO3 is a polyatomic ion, so you can put here bracket and put write the 2 at the base as a subscript. What you will do? Just omit this bracket. You will write Ca, but it consists 2 valency, so don't omit it, and you will write HCO3 whole twice. So this is the formula of calcium hydrogen carbonate. Okay, so you can write the formula of calcium hydrogen carbonate. HCO3 whole twice. Got it? Okay, so like that you can make the formula. You can take the another example, formula of calcium nitrate. So you can make the formula of calcium nitrate. Next formula, calcium nitrate. Okay, I have already told you what is the radical of calcium nitrate. NO3 negative, it means its valency is -1. So now we will write Ca and NO3 negative, it means you can write the valency here 1, here 2 valency, cross over the valency, what you will get? Ca -1 at the base as in subscript and NO3 bracket should be there and you will write +2 at the base as in subscript. What you will do? Omit the first bracket, that will be in left side. So you will write Ca and NO3 whole twice, plus and minus sign should be omitted. Okay, so final formula is CaNO3 whole twice. This is the final formula of calcium nitrate. So you can write the formulas like that. If you have any problem regarding, then you can learn the valencies of polyatomic ions as well as cations and anions. Okay, now thank you and have a nice day.